These are the magic faces, superstars of the modeling world. A pretty face can earn $2,000 a day, $300,000 a year. It's a $50 million business, all based on illusion. We call our fairy tale Beautiful Baby, Beautiful. Beautiful Baby, Beautiful. It's what the photographer says when he captures that moment of illusion. In this dream world, all girls are 5'9", weigh 115 pounds, have long limbs, blue eyes, and never stop smiling. Men are all 6 feet and magnificent. No one is old. No one is ugly. No one is poor. No one ever cries. And beauty is all that matters.
There. Shake it again. Yeah. Put the other leg forward, Christy. There. There you go.
Christie Brinkley has hooked the brass ring on the modeling merry-go-round. At 25, yeah. Christy grosses some $2,000 a day.
You, maybe, you know? Yeah. Good, Christy. Good. There. Okay, now try to get up.
This golden girl from California has run up the astounding record of appearing on more than 100 magazine covers.
Over. There.
There's no green.
That's okay, that's okay. There, that was it. Good. Lean over with the hair.
I don't think of myself as the model, you know. I've always thought of myself more as just me, Christy. I wake up in the morning and pull on my bathing suit, and everybody in Malibu wears bathing suits, so we all look the same. Well, I started modeling in Paris because I had gone over there first to study art and travel Europe and all that. And one day I was walking down the street and I bumped right into this guy that said, "Are you a model?" And I said, "No." And he said, "Well, would you like to be?" And I said, "No." And he said, "But there's such good money in this, and you should really try it." So I thought, well, why not? You know, I was struggling as a poor, starving artist in Paris, and I thought, why not?
You know what I would do?
Huh?
I think we shouldn't do it so neat. I think we should go bang with
yeah,
it.
Yeah, that's a good idea.
Yeah, you know, really? And just go.
So it could be stringy.
And just keep coming out of the water.
$4 a minute. That should make it easier to stay cool in the hot sun, or to be poked, painted, and primped for 12 hours a day, or to go to bed hungry.
Look, tomorrow we're just gonna have to sacrifice it. Tomorrow morning, real early.
Oh, well, no enchiladas tonight.
Well, we got it wet, we got it curly, we got it flying, we got it in
got
the
it
face,
first,
we got it out of the face.
Thinking, yeah.
Yeah, we got it. Cross the lipstick.
So bad, really. The I just saw you in red.
Yeah, you were absolutely right. Red's my favorite color.
Thanks.
Yeah.
Janice Dickinson is a woman who spends her days creating illusions, but has few of her own. Her body and face have sold oceans of perfume and miles of lace.
Watch your neck, Janice. Front of your neck. You've got to get a position where it doesn't do that. There you go. Good.
Dickinson will pose in skimpy lingerie. It's twice the money. She's a realist about modeling and plays it for what it's worth. For her, that's close to $250,000 a year.
Okay, hang on. That's beautiful. Like that.
Okay, I'll try and hold it.
It's not exciting. It is not glamorous. It's a bunch of hard work because I have to keep my ass in shape.
I got to get up at bed every morning and run Central Park. I have to bicycle. I have to swim. I have to keep my butt in shape. Because now the new models, they're all 15, 16 years old. I'm 24. Well, I left home day after graduating high school because I knew if I stayed in Florida, I would probably end up with all the rest of my friends laying on the beach, eating quaaludes, smoking grass, doing drugs, and I did not want to be part of that scene. I knew I had to get out of it. So I left the day after I graduated high school, went to New York. I had $4 in my pocket. And I stayed there 3 months, going after appointment after appointment after appointment, doors slamming in my face. No one wanted to take my picture. No one wanted to give me work. So I was trying to imitate all these models in the magazines with these sultry, passionate looks on their face, selling, let's say, lipstick or perfume, you know, looking very deep, dark, and mysterious, like that. And I thought to myself, Christ blood, I mean, that's not me. I'm too hyper-tense, hyperactive, sportive. I've got to laugh and have a good time in my work because I feel good. Or that's how I want people to see me because that's how I am inside. So I had one photograph in my portfolio, which is what these poor models schlep around in the streets to show people so they can get work. So I had one photograph, and it was something like this. It was like, I see these girls coming in with these whining looks in their eyes, like, oh, I want to be a star. I want to be just like Janice Dickinson. I want to look, you know, I want to be just like them. They tell me, they say, what can I do? And I say, don't do anything. Go back to school. Get something up here. Have something else going on. Because if you just cling to the fact that you want to be a model, I won't say what I'm thinking. You can't do it.
We're from Omaha, Nebraska. Win it all. Win it all. We're from Omaha, Nebraska.
There are over 1,000 modeling schools in the country. Each year, they graduate some 50,000 hopefuls who pursue the dream in New York City. Only 10 of these hopefuls will land any modeling job. And only one in a million will make it to the top.
Anyone should ask him, we're the best in runway action. We're from Omaha, Nebraska. Win it all. Win it all!
Nancy Bounds, and I have the Nancy Bounds Modeling School in Omaha, Nebraska, and these are my kids.
My name is Susan Hankin. I'm 19 years old, and I'm from Omaha, Nebraska. I decided to enter into the field professionally about 2 years ago, although all my life, all girls just kind of dream about being a model.
People want to be models because they don't want to spend the rest of their lives doing something very humdrum. Maybe they might do that later on in life. But when you're young like these people are, after all, they have many years to decide what they'd really like to do with their lives. In school, they learn to have poise. They learn how to perform in front of people without feeling uptight. They learn how to be themselves and be happy with themselves and acquire tremendous self-image, which I think is important to success in any career. I know these kids, and I love them dearly.
My parents at first were a little hesitant, but after graduation, when they seen the graduation itself on stage, they were just thrilled to death. Thrilled. Both of them. Why, my mom, all along, would agree with anything I wanted to do.
Again! We're from Omaha, Nebraska, win it all, win it all. We're from Omaha, Nebraska, win it all, win it all.
And that's what 30-year-old Cristina Ferrare seems to have done. Win it all.
Can I have my brush, please?
Cristina's one of a kind. There's no other model who has a life quite like hers.
Is that my sleepy girl? Let me get up, okay?
Ravishing beauty, she has two children, a Fifth Avenue duplex, a 500-acre ranch, and is about to buy an East Coast country estate. She's married to 55-year-old multimillionaire John DeLorean.
Do you want me to walk you in the elevator like I do
trying right now in a vain attempt to lose about 9 pounds. Of course, that's the story of my life. But anyway, I'm trying to do it to try to get back down to my working weight. I don't even know why I even tried this because, well, I have to because I like to eat quite a bit. However, exercise is good for skinny people as well as for all you porkers out there. Gets rid of all the aches and pains in the old bod, and you feel better. Can you give me some cheekbones?
Lots of them.
Okay, I only need 2.
Why does she model? Because she loves it. But there's something more. She calls the shots, choosing when and what she models. Her $300,000 a year is her money, her independence. She's a superstar and undeniably considered the fairest of them all.
Can I get this?
Yes, you can hang it up on your refrigerator.
There are 3 essentials to a modeling shoot. The model, the camera, and a big electric fan. Models have to get used to posing in gale force winds, even the superstars, and spending long, uncomplaining hours pleasing a photographer who can make or break their career. Ford Modeling Agency in New York is the biggest and most powerful agency in the world. It controls the lives of some 352 men and women,